Hi, and in today's tutorial I'm going to show you how to create this celebration poster in Word. So the first thing we're going to do is to enter in all of our graphics. So let's go to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down and select the square. Then just click and drag out a rectangle and make sure it spreads across your page. There we go. The next thing to do is to change the color. So to change the color of a shape, just make sure it's selected and go to Shape Format. Click on the drop down. You can select from any of these colors, but if you can't see a color of your choice, go to More Fill Colors. Here you have a color wheel. You can move this little circle all the way around your color wheel to select a color of your choice. The color will appear here in the square. And then you can use this lighten and darken slider here to select further color tones. If you're not quite sure, you can always select the ones at the top here and they'll just give you more color options. So I've previously selected some other colors, so I'm going to select this color here. Now, because I want to create a gradient across this, so a whiter gradient in the center, I'm going to go to Shape Format and go all the way over to Format Pane and click. Here you'll be presented with another menu and we need to go to this bucket icon here. Go to the drop down Fill and go down to Gradient Fill. Now here I've previously got this default which I don't want. So I need to go down to the slider here and I've got these four markers. Now I only want two. So I need to select one and go to the minus sign, select another one and go to the minus sign, and now I've only got two. So on the outside one, you can select it, it's got the orange outline, go to color, click on the drop down and I'll select that color again. And then on the other end, I'm going to select white. But as you can see, my gradient goes from top to bottom on my page and I want to change that. So go to type, click and go down to radial and then go to direction. You can't see it, but it's the third one along and select the radial. Now it's the wrong way around. I want the white in the middle. So all I need to do is just change around these markers and then I can just place that. You can move these sliders. As you see, when you move them, it will change your gradient. So move it to where you want. I want mine about there. You can also use your transparency sliders and your brightness sliders as well. It's completely up to you. Now I'm going to insert some more shapes. So go to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down, and I'm going to go to this square with the curved corners, rounded rectangle. Click and drag out a rectangle. And with this one, it's got a little yellow box. Now, if any of your shapes have a yellow box, it means there's further adjustments that you can do. For this one, it relates to the corner, so I'm just going to pull it to the right and make sure that my corners are fully rounded. Then to format this shape, I'm going to select it, go back over to the bucket icon. I'm going to go down to line because actually I don't want a borderline. There is a small borderline that comes with each shape that's inserted. And for this one again, I want a gradient fill, but I'm going to change this color here. Click on color. Let's just move this over. I'm just going to click on this color here. And then to give this a little bit more interest, we're actually going to give the shape a 3D effect. So with this, we need to go to this icon here, Effects. Go down to 3D Format. Go down to Bevel. Click on the drop down. And I'm going to select this bevel here. As you can see, we've got a nice bevel on the outside of our shape. And then you can move this bevel, you can thicken those borders there. You see where it goes around the outside. So all you need to do is use the up and down arrows here. So I'm going to click up and mine will go to around about 16. Now, once I've formatted my first shape, I can just copy and paste for all my additional shapes. So I have four additional shapes. So all I'm going to do is you can use copy and paste, Command or Control C, Command or Control V, but I'm going to select it and hold down my Alt key, click and drag, and then do that again. And now I have all the graphics I need. So this box is going to go at the bottom and I'm going to reformat those edges to about there. And then this one I'm going to enlarge. Now, if you want them all exactly the same size, the best thing to do is to format one and then just copy and paste the other. So I'm looking at these now. I don't want them all to be the same size, but probably all the same width. So if you select it, go to shape format, and you can go over and see the dimensions of your shape. So the width of mine is 11.83. I can highlight that or select it, copy it, Command or Control C, and then I can go to this one here, and then I can simply just paste it in, Command or Control V, and press Enter. Same with this one, select it, Command or Control V to paste, press Enter. Now all of these will be the same width. They may not be the same height, but they're certainly the same width. Now I'm just going to change the color of this one. So select it, back over to the bucket, and then over to this slider color here. And then I'm going to change the color to a purple, and then change this one to a blue. And then at the bottom here, this one I think I'll change to this color here. That's it. Great. This one I'm just going to lower the transparency of that white. So select it, and then I'm just going to lower the transparency so you can't quite see it as much, because I'm going to put some white text on there. So now we've got most of our graphics in, I'm just going to select them all. So hold down your Command or Control key and click on all of them. Then go to Align and then select Align to Center, and then they'll all be lined up to the center of the document. So now we're going to go and get some background graphics, and we're going to hop onto the internet, and we're going to go to this site here. It's called SVG, which is the name of a file, and then SILH, SIL, which is short for silhouette.com. Now in here you've got a search bar, and if you just simply type paint in, you will normally get this response. So there's lots and lots of different paint splats here. And at the top, you've got all the different color options that you can use. So I've used this purple here. And then all you need to do is go to the paint splat you want, click on it, and then you can choose to download a PNG or an SVG. You can download a SVG. And then all you need to do is go to Insert, Picture, Picture from File. And then if you go to your downloads, then you'll see that file at the top. I'm just going to go to another file where I've chosen to put all of my different graphics, select one that I've downloaded and click Insert. Now, many times when you insert a picture and you've got other graphics, it will be hiding behind the background. Okay, if that happens, you're going to have to move your background, select the shape, go to Picture Format, go to Wrap Text, click on the drop down and go to In Front of Text. We can move the background back. And then using this circular icon at the top, we can rotate this anywhere we want. Oh, we can make that bigger. However we like. And then we can also make some alterations. If you go to Picture Format, you can go to Color, and then we can slightly change the color on this. Corrections, we can make it a little bit brighter. And we can also have a little bit of fun over here. We can go to Artistic Effects, and then you can select any one of these if you want to. Let's use that one. And then we can again move the slider left or right. So once we've got that, you can see it's now covering all of the graphics that we recently did. So we've got to send it back. So make sure it's selected, click on it, go to Picture Format, and go to this icon saying Send Backwards. Just keep clicking on it, and you'll notice that things come forward. There we go. And again, you can move this anywhere you want to, and you can also rotate it. So the next thing I want to do is to insert another one. So go to Insert, Picture, Picture from File, and then I'm going to insert this one here and click Insert. Again, it's disappeared, so Wrap Text in Front of Text. There we go. And again, we go to Artistic Effects. Let's choose any of these, let's see what just happens. There we go, that's the one I wanted. Let me just show you. No, it still won't show you. Is this one here. So again, we want to move this one backwards. Let's just enlarge that a bit more. So again, go to Send Backwards and just keep clicking until all of the graphics come in front. Perfect. And again, go to insert, picture, picture from file. And this time I'm going to look for a white sparkle, like a firework. Now, unfortunately, when you select a file which has a white graphic in it, it doesn't show up in your files. So what you need to do is insert them and then you need to label them, which I haven't done. So just bear with me. I will cut this bit out while I find the right file. Okay, there we go. This is the one I wanted. So we're going to pop this one up here. Hold down my Alt or Option key, click and drag. And then deselect, reselect one because I only want another third one. Actually, I do want one more, so reselect that one. Deselect, reselect this one. And here's where you can just really customize your design. Have as big or small as you like. And then we'll pop that one up there. There we go. So that's fairly quick to get those designs in. And now it's just down to the text. So let's go to insert, word art, and let's just choose this black one here. Let's move this over here. So to customize the text, first I'm going to click inside and change the text. And then deselect it, reselect it, because I can now make customizations without having to select the text. Go to home. I'm going to select text color of white. So the font I want is called Bellania. Now you can find lots of different fonts online. There's lots that come with Word, but if you want to find out about how to download various fonts, then I'll put the link in the description below. So there's my font there. And then I'm going to change that to font size 55, press enter. There we go. And then I'm going to go to text options over here. You have shape options here, but now we've got some text in, we've got text options. I'm going to go to the A here. I'm going to go to 3D format. I'm going to go to bevel. So I'm going to give this one a slight bevel, just select this one here. There we go. Not sure if we can make this bold. Yeah, so I'm going to make that bold as well. And then we'll just move that up to the top here. Now there will be lots of moving around. So I'm going to grab this graphic and I'm going to pull it forward, go to picture format, bring forward. So I want that graphic in on top. There we go. It's on top of my text. So now we've formatted this. I'm going to copy and paste it. So select it, hold down my Alt or Option key, click and drag. I'm now going to rotate it back. There we go, to zero. And then I'm going to change the font, actually deselect, reselect, just change that font there to Cooper. There we go. And the size of that will be 75. It's not on there, so 75, press enter. And then just change the text. And then move that within the box. Now, what I will do is probably need to move these boxes down. We'll line them all up again afterwards so they just don't interfere. Okay, so what I need to do on this one is just select it, go to shadow, click on the drop down and just select no shadow, and it takes the shadow off of the text. Now, once you're happy, again, hold down the Alt key, click and drag. And then I'm going to click and drag some more. And then I need some text at the bottom as well. Okay, so let's change the text here. 18th. And then this one to birthday. Change this one to Bellania again. Go to the fonts, go to Bellania. Stretch that out. There we go. Just reduce the size of that slightly. Let's go to 72. Oh no, not two, 72. Press enter. There we are. And then we'll put party here. And then in this one, we're going to type the date. I'm just going to paste it in. There we go. And this font size is 22, Cooper 22. And then I'm just going to copy and paste that one. Put some more text in. And just paste my text in. There we go. And then finally, we'll put the address in. And there we go. Whoops. Move that up. There we go. Now we've got everything into our poster. Now we just need to move it around and make sure it's all centered. So to center your text to your text box, let's make sure that this is as small as possible, this text box. There we go. What you will need to do is select the text, hold down your Command or Control key and select the box underneath. Go to Shape Format, Align, click on the drop down and align to middle. Now that will line up these two boxes here, but sometimes this doesn't work. As you can see, that's no longer in the center of the box. But let's line it up to the middle because that will work. So see these boxes here are slightly off. Go back up to Align, Align to Center. Now the text is aligned to the center, but not to the middle. So deselect, reselect the text and use your arrow keys just to move that up. And then you can move it up by eye until you're happy with where it is in the box. Once you are happy, if you don't want them to move, select them both again, holding down that Command or Control key, go to Group and select Group. And then this is now one element. You can see Celebrate has disappeared behind. So let's bring that forwards, go to Bring Forwards, keep clicking. And it will come forwards. Same with the 18th, select it. Okay, if you keep selecting other boxes, just move it out of the way for the time being. Select the 18th, select the box underneath, Command or Control key, align to center, so that's lined up. Deselect, reselect the 18th, and let's use the arrow keys to move that down. Don't worry, I know it's not all in the center at the moment, probably about there. Reselect the box below. Go to Group and select Group, Align, Align to Center. And that's lined up to the center. We'll do that with the box here, Align, Align to Center. I don't know why, I think Word's got a gremlin this morning, it's going really slowly. So let's move Birthday up and center that. So again, Shape Format, Align, Align to Center. And again with Party, we'll select the word. Let's make that really small. Select the box behind, Align, Align to Center. Deselect, reselect party, just move that down or up with your arrow keys. Once you're happy, select the box behind, group and select group. Once it's grouped together, go to align, align to center. And that's all now perfectly lined up. And again, with this one, you can actually do the same with all of these. Select them all at the same time. Select the box behind, align, align to center. Once you're happy, go to group, select group, and then go to align, align to center. Once that's all lined up, let's bring these forward, these little stars or fireworks. Go to Picture Format, bring forwards, just keep clicking. And eventually we'll pop forwards, there we go. And this one, or alternative, just click on the drop down and bring to front. So now you can go ahead and you can save that either as a Word document or a PDF. You can print it straight out, or of course you can send it to your printers. If you don't want to do this yourself, there are links below where you can download the template. But if that has helped you today, please like and subscribe and have a great day.